tense because there isn't much of an answer, but if an actor from your favorite fandom came out and said something that was in bad taste, would you feel regret about your tattoo? So I guess in that sense, like, if you had, like, if Joanna Newsom, for some reason, said something offensive, would you ever experience some sort of regret if something like that happened to you?
It would definitely be a bridge that I would have to cross if I came to it. It would definitely depend on what they said and if it was something really terrible or if it was something that could be taken into interpretation, if they issued an apology. So I feel like there's a lot of elements that go into that thought process, and it would definitely have to be something that would go on a case-by-case basis, I believe. I feel like it would be a different scenario if somebody said something rude, rescinded it with an apology, said they knew they were wrong, or it would be a very different scenario if, like, an artist went and sexually harassed a woman or hit someone or something like that. I feel like those are two very different situations, so it would just really depend on what they did and how they handled it.
I think it's also really difficult right now. I think right now is a time where receipts are available on everybody, and I think different people have different problems and ideas from different things. Like, there's definitely things I don't know about my favorite celebrities, and I think now is a time where we're hoping that people are perfect people and that they are omnipotent beings and they are capable of only good. So I think either there's a place for forgiveness in there, or just if you have a certain feeling and if something, you were given a feeling about something, if it was your favorite song or your favorite author or your favorite show, I think that it doesn't invalidate that feeling that you have. And I was telling Hannah earlier, like, when I first got into Charles Bukowski, and, like, I really loved him, and I loved him only for his writing. And his writing does have, like, an autobiographical sense, although it's written usually by a perspective of, like, a fictional character. So I really enjoyed that. But then, you know, you find out about the author and you find out that they have done problematic things. And then you're like, oh no, what about the feelings I had before? Like, are those valid? And I think that's just something that comes with, I guess, a family tattoo. I think, like, I've always been somebody who, like, if I liked a band, I would listen to their music, and I like, didn't know the lead singer's name, and people would be like, you don't even like that band if you don't know. But I think that, like, all of that just comes from, like, your own personal interpretation of it, and I think that it's a really great question that neither of us could really come up with a concrete answer, because I don't know what I would do. Like, I don't know, I haven't thought about getting my, like, Charles Bukowski tattoo removed. I just know that it's a part of it, but it's not something I think about every single day or once a week or almost ever. So I guess, like, cross that bridge when you can do it, as you said, but
I feel like you have to have a margin of forgiveness for people as well, because we are human, and everybody, including celebrities and idolizing people, do mistakes and continue to put in their mouth, and as long as they handle it the correct way, I believe that, like, there is a margin of forgiveness for everyone.
I totally agree, and yeah, it doesn't invalidate, like, what you loved about that person to begin with. So, which I think kind of leads us into our next question, which I think is really good, and it's, how long should you be a fan before you get the tattoo? And I really like your answer.
So, my answer to this was more about my Naruto tattoo. So, I started watching Naruto actually less than a year ago. Last January, I had left school, I had just moved in with my boyfriend's parents, I didn't have a job, and it was just a really dark place in my life. I had a lot of free time on my hands, and my boyfriend was a huge, huge Naruto fan. And he said, you should start watching this, like, it will really, like, take up your time, give you something to do. And in the short amount of time that I spent binge-watching the entire show, it had such a profound impact on my life that it's even hard for me to put it into words. Like, the amount that I related with the characters, so many of their personalities and their struggles, and what a lot of them went through, it just really struck a chord with me, and I knew it was something that was gonna really affect my life in a positive way and just give me an outlet that I could relate to and people that I could talk to about something I was passionate about. So after I'd finished his show, I knew I definitely wanted at least one Naruto tattoo to kind of commemorate that. It had definitely kind of pulled me out of this dark place in my life and given me a sense of community to talk to other people who were really into the show, and it had affected them in the same way it affected me.
I think that's super cool, and I don't think that there has to be a timeline. And everyone gets tattooed for different reasons, and everyone kind of has their own method to be tattooed. And I think a lot of people believe, like, you have to love something for 300 days and then you're qualified for the tattoo, and I don't think that's true. I think you can fall in love with something immediately, you can fall in love with the design immediately, and I think you knew you were impacted by Naruto, and you knew that you wanted to represent that, and I think that that's cool. And I think only somebody would come out of it, I think people would be like, that's not long enough, but who gets to dictate that? I don't think that anyone really can. So I think I don't think you have to wait. I don't know. Sure, maybe a week might help.
But yeah, definitely. I mean, I didn't watch the first episode and immediately oh yeah, man, I love this show so much. I want to get Naruto's face tattooed on my face. That wasn't my thought process. Like I said, I have the Akatsuki cloud. You can kind of see here. And I do want a portrait of Itachi as well, somewhere on my leg. But the Akatsuki Cloud is just kind of like the small homage to Naruto that I have right now, especially because Itachi is my favorite character, and his personality on the show, his character really just stuck with me, and I really just loved everything that he stood for as a person and as a character in the show, and I loved all of his actions. I think he was such an admirable character. That this is kind of like my homage to the show and to Itachi before I actually have his face tattoo.
The little trial tattoo, the dabble into the fandom. Oh, are you planning on any new fandom tattoos?
Definitely want more Pokemon tattoos. I want a Master Ball, just because I think it looks cool. It's pink and purple, it's girly and fun, and I love it. And my boyfriend and I are also hoping to get Umbreon and Espeon tattoos. Our tattoo artist painted this really beautiful painting for us that was an Umbreon and Espeon. The Umbreon had a pink collar and a pink glow behind it, and the Espeon had a black moon behind it. So they really correspond with each other, and Espeon is one of my favorite ones. So I'm really hoping we can make that happen soon. Other than that, there's a couple other tattoos that I do want, especially having to do with the fans and different artists. I want another lights tattoo, and I want a citizen tattoo. Repping my citizen shirt right now.
So good.
So there's definitely a couple more fandom tattoos that I think will end up on my body.
I think for me, someone did ask me, are you gonna get a Stranger Things tattoo? And I think it would be so appropriate. I'm a little worried about season 2 coming out, because I'm I don't know if I'll like that. But then, like I said previously, that doesn't matter. It doesn't invalidate how I felt about it. So I was thinking about getting an 11 tattoo. But other than that, I do plan on getting a Sonic the Hedgehog tattoo. I'm totally game for that. I'm just kind of looking for an artist, and then looking at myself naked and figuring out where it will belong, because I feel like sometimes with those sillier tattoos, you kind of have to put them somewhere more strategic. And by silly, I kind of just mean I don't know what he's gonna be doing. I picture him running, so I'm all right,
gotta go fast.
Where can you go? And then so my back is based off of the folklore behind YS, Joanna Newsom's third album. So once the top of my back kind of corresponds with that, I think when I'm adding to the bottom of my back, closer to my butt, I'm definitely gonna go into her albums and really try to imagine, pick up more of the imagery that she conveyed, and it's definitely just all based on her. So hopefully she doesn't say anything weird in the newspaper. Why would I be reading a newspaper? Do you feel like getting an abstract design representing your fandom is better than getting the actual thing?
I think this is another question that's definitely asked for people who believe that you will regret regret your fandom tattoos, thinking that maybe, like, oh, it's more artsy and more abstract. If you stop liking it, it will be more valid. And I don't really agree with this. If I'm going to get something, I'd rather just get the imagery exactly how the original artist had it drawn. We took my Vulpix originally straight from one of the Pokemon cards, so it wasn't just, like, drawn up just based on the Vulpix my artist was thinking of. I've seen some, like, stylized abstracts to do Ghibli art before, and if that's your thing, like, that's totally cool. It's just definitely not up my alley. I'd rather have the original art, like, as the artist intended it to be, and that just recognizable image that people will see and be like, oh, hey, that's a cat bus, that's a Pokemon, instead of having, like, a differently drawn version of it that makes it a little bit harder to interpret.
I think I definitely agree with you. I think that's how I feel, and I think, like, if I were to get fandom, like, more specific fandom tattoos, I think that's what I would lean towards. I think, you know, a lot of the fandoms right now that I view, I think, are super iconic. Like, you see the King of the Hill tattoos and Hello Kitty, and you want to be able to see them and view them, and I think share your fandom, and that's why you got them. My more abstract tattoos are kind of just what fit my body best. I had some band tattoos, and because I had some text tattoos that I really wasn't happy with, just because the text I had, I felt like people were reading it and coming up to me, and I felt uncomfortable about that. But that's just, like, my own feeling of being uncomfortable all the time. So I think I strayed more from, like, lyric-based tattoos and got more imagery-based ones. But I think because of that, like, it lacks that, like, interaction that I would want from being a part of the fandom. Like, I have a yellow spider, yellow leaf tattoo, and I feel like if I were to go to a Me Without You show, people probably wouldn't pick up on it right away. But at the same time, I want to be like, I'm a big fan. So, I don't know. I feel like you said, because it isn't, like, super direct, it might not represent it as well. So if I was going to get more direct ones, I feel like they would have that better response. But I think it does have a lot to do with, like, people being afraid of regretting the tattoo. And I think that's, like, the airiness of a lot of the questions we got. I think a lot of people feel hesitance about getting tattooed in general, though. I think if you know that, like, you're going to be tattooed and that you plan on being, like, a fully tattooed person, or, you know, like, I want my whole arm done, my whole leg done, my whole stomach, I think it's a lot easier to fit in these little tattoos exactly how they are. But I think people who are interested in getting fandom tattoos who have no other tattoos, I think that it's more of a thought process that they should consider. Like I said earlier, like, John has, like, one tattoo, so if he was going to get a fandom tattoo, if he was going to get a Pokemon tattoo, and that's his only tattoo, I think it held a lot more weight than if I were to get one, which would, it could be blended with all my other tattoos. Obviously, people could single it out because they're familiar with seeing it, but I think that regret and that thought process wouldn't be as held as heavy for me. What do you think?
I definitely agree with that. As someone who has a lot of tattoos, I definitely have, like, a lot of, like, really small ones that I probably wouldn't have gotten if I only had one tattoo. There's definitely a lot more room for getting, like, so-called, like, silly tattoos if you have a lot of them.
Yeah, I totally agree. So, I think that, yeah, like, a lot of the questions I think that we read may have come from people who are interested in getting their very first tattoo, and it's a fandom tattoo, and I think that's really great because, like we said throughout this video, like, if that's where your heart is, and that's who your friends are, and that's, like, the niche group that you want to be in, I think that that's super cool. But yeah, consider it, obviously, but it just might not be our opinion because regret doesn't really play into too much of our goals. I think both of us want to be completely tattooed, so having that little tattoo might be different for us.
My very first tattoo was a fandom tattoo. On my 18th birthday, I got a dagger on my arm that says Fight Off Your Demons, obviously a brand new reference if you're familiar with brand new. But I did also get my second tattoo 2 days later. And it was also another pretty big one. So I definitely knew I wanted to be heavily tattooed from the get, which definitely, like, affected my decision and made it not so much of a weight of what I was going to get for my first tattoo, just like, all right, I want to start. I know what I want. Like, all right, we can just start checking them off.
How do you feel about getting the exact tattoo that a celebrity has to represent your fandom?
I definitely think there's better choices of tattoos to get if you want to represent a celebrity or someone you admire. I'm a huge fan of Lights. Obviously, I have her signature tattooed on me, but I've seen a lot of people get her exact tattoos before. She has a tattoo on her finger from the day that her and Bo Boken got married that's like a bunch of little symbols, and I've seen a lot of people with that. She has another tattoo on one of her fingers that says Found in Love, and the amount of times I've seen that tattoo on the same finger in the same font is kind of ridiculous, and people are like, oh, this is my Lights tattoo. But I think that as a fan, there's a lot more things you could do to like pay homage to that person or that group rather than just get their exact tattoo.
I totally agree. I think when I was growing up, Britney Spears had that really iconic, it was like a little, I'll pull up an image of it. It's like a little fairy and the wings are a bee for Britney.
Oh, I've definitely seen that.
And I remember everybody getting that tattoo, and I wasn't sure if it was like, oh, my favorite celebrity has tattoos and that's my only understanding of tattoos. This is my first time dabbling. I mean, when Britney Spears was popular, how many celebrities were tattooed at that time? Not so many. So maybe people are coming in and they're turning 18, they can get tattooed, they're viewing Lights, and they're like, this is my impression of tattoos. But I think a lot of that, I think with more research and more understanding of tattoos, people would want something more representative of them, something more clever about the fandom and more representative of the music. I think a lot of these copy tattoos just come from people wanting to idolize their celebrity and not representative of being tattooed as a part of the fandom, but more along the lines of wanting to be that person.
Definitely. And I think a tattoo also means a lot more if like you take a lyric from your favorite band that means a lot to you, then it kind of mixes that artist and also what you're feeling about them and puts them together, as opposed to just like taking something like, I love this artist, I'm gonna get their tattoo. That's more just something of them. If you take a lyric that you love and you get that tattooed along with some imagery, I feel like that really combines like your feelings towards the artist and the artist's work themselves into a more like unique tattoo that's made specifically for you and things that you love and are passionate about.
Yeah, I think that's totally true, and I think both of those things show different things. Like, do you love the music or do you love the person? So I think, you know, if you get the lyrics tattoo and if you get the imagery of the music that you love, the album art, that means something a little more different than getting the exact same tattoo that the celebrity has, because that's wanting to look like them and idolizing them. But I think both of us are people who have had our tattoos ripped off and stolen, and we've actually seen them on different people in real life. So I don't think I would ever be comfortable taking somebody's tattoo and getting it for my own, because I know how it feels and it's shitty.
Definitely not. Celebrity or not, I still think it sucks to have your tattoo ripped off.
Yeah, totally.
For anyone.
Finally, to conclude this episode, what are your favorite fandoms?
Pokemon. Studio Ghibli, Lights, Naruto, all the things I have tattoos of. I'm trying to think if there's any other fandoms that I would consider myself to be in. I'm not really sure if this would consider as a fandom or as like an interest, but I definitely want a tattoo that represents my love of vinyl and records, and it's not really so a fandom because it's such a wide thing, but it really is a community and it's something that's a huge part of my life. So I'd love to get a tattoo that would like kind of pay homage to that and how much impact it's had on my life and all the people I've met through fun events.
I think that's super cool. I think, you know, I'll see comments sometimes that are like, are you gonna get a YouTube tattoo? Are you gonna get a Quicken tattoo? And I always thought like, I mean, I was like, oh, that's so egotistical to get such a thing, but it's true. I think it's something that is a huge part of my life, and I think it is a fandom I'm into. I think I go outside of my house and I'm like, oh, no one else knows about YouTube, and then I come back home on the computer and it's like, yeah, it's popping. Who uploaded today? So I think, I don't know, I think in the future I might think about getting a little YouTube tattoo, but I'm not sure. Other than that, I don't know. I think that's a fandom that I belong in. I don't know if it's true. I watch all the YouTubers and I'm at home like, everyone else is watching TV. I think, what fandoms do I belong to?
Sonic,
my father. I think I'm definitely in there with Studio Ghibli. I feel like I'm in a lot of like private anime fandoms. School Days was one of my favorite animes ever. And although people are like, what the fuck was that anime? I kind of just want like a nice boat tattoo. I don't know. And then all the music I love. It's complicated, but there's definitely a long list of things I just geek the fuck out about. I don't know. Complicated. But, thank you guys for watching this today. The video is a little long, but I think you're into it. I think this was really cool. Give this video a thumbs up if you like interview style videos. Who would you want to see on the channel? What questions do you have? Thank you so much, Hannah, for being on here.
Thank you. It's an honor to be here. I'm actually a longtime Quicken fan, so I'm very excited to be here.
Check her out on Instagram. I'll leave all those links down below. And until next time, guys. Bye.
Out of cards.
Ah, this guy's toast.
Tonight, a tale of good.
I'm out of cards.
This guy's toast.
Argo versus Valera.
The pleasure is mine.
Fast rule!
This guy's toast. Thank you.
The Brotherhood shall prevail.
Feel the power.
Versus Malfurion.
I must protect you the while.
Thank you. tale of terrible tragedy.
For no one.
Thank you. Morgul versus Gul'dan.
Your soul shall be mine.
Girls versus guys. What girls use their phones for?
Oh my God, that reminds me. You know who's a slut? Every girl I've ever met who's prettier than me. Now that that's established, we can talk about my weird vaginal discharge for 45 minutes.
What guys use their phones for?
Hey, this is Charlie from 3225. I'm just making sure our appointment's still on for Friday.
How girls walk. How guys walk. How girls get ready to go somewhere.
Sweetie, can we skip the party? I hate everything about myself.
How guys get ready to go somewhere.
Good to go.
What girls do for fun.
I want to go shopping. Where's my boyfriend's money?
What guys do for fun. This is a girl trying to catch something.
I didn't feel that one.
What a guy takes with him when going out. What a girl takes with her when going out.
Got my purse.
How a guy farts. How a girl farts.
Oh God! Did anybody hear that? I'm a monster! Oh, it's so gross!
How a guy goes to the bathroom. How a girl goes to the bathroom.
Maybe just one more layer. Maybe just one more on top of that. You know what? I don't have to go to the bathroom today. I'll just hold it until I die.
How a guy eats food. How a girl eats food.
I'm full.
How a guy responds to criticism.
You're a stupid, worthless piece of shit, and no one would ever love you. Okay.
How a girl responds to criticism.
You're a stupid, ugly piece of shit, and no one will ever love you.
Hey guys, I know I look super creepy today, but let's go ahead and talk about 10 things I hate about relationships. Okay, thing number one. When people imply forever, they rarely mean it.
Dale and Vicky forever, right, baby?
I'm never gonna stop loving you, baby.
We're soulmates. That means we're eternal.
Let's never be apart, baby.
Promise you'll never leave me.
We are forever and ever.
Let's be together forever.
Hey, Dale.
Yes, sweetie pie.
I'm leaving you for emo Charlie. Yeah, he's kind of better than you in every way.
Yeah, and half your age.
Age is just a number.
And a jail cell is just a room.
Thing number two, having to deal with your significant other's psychotic exes.
Hello.
I'm gonna hurt you in places you never knew existed.
Who is this?
Oh, you know exactly who this is, homewrecker.
Oh, yeah. You know she came to me, right?
You
you had sex with her?
I said she came to me.
Oh.
You know, it's been about 7 weeks, Dale. Maybe you should move on.
Oh, okay, I'll move on when you're dead. How's that?
Okay, if you're threatening me, I'm gonna have to contact the police.
No.
What?
I'm sorry.
Okay, fine.
Oh, I'm gonna kill you.
Okay, bye.
Thing number three. In relationships, you often have to hold in your farts.
Oh my god, that was such a good movie.
Yeah, I like watching shitty chick flicks with a guy slash girl who'll never make love to me.
Because we're cousins.
Yeah, so you keep reminding me.
That, and because you can't even see your own freaking penis.
Ugh, whatever.
Why does it smell like rotten eggs and barf?
I thought you'd be gone longer.
Thing number four, having to constantly worry about their safety when they're away.
Hey, Vicky, I'm headed to the ski park, okay?
Oh, sweetie, wait. Take this.
I'm not wearing this.
Please, baby, I don't want a retarded boyfriend.
Oh, you mean like your last one?
Hello? Hey, just FYI, I tapped my house, which you're living in, and what you just said wasn't funny.
Okay, now you're super creeping me out.
Thing number five, those awkward and often irrational feelings of jealousy.
Hey, Charlie, I'm totally gonna go drop Dale's stuff off, okay?
Oh, okay.
Here's your shit, you piece of fuck.
OMG, thanks, bitch.
Hey, Charlie, I'm back.
Hey, how'd it go with Dale?
Did she sleep with him?
Oh, everything went great.
What do you mean by great?
She slept with him, didn't she?
Oh. I mean, I didn't have to see his disgusting repulsive face for more than 5 seconds.
Oh, okay.
Thing number six. Not feeling good enough.
Charlie, I think you might be prettier than me.
Don't say that. You're beautiful.
I am?
Well, for a 42-year-old.
Ah!
Thing number seven. Having to adopt a family which most likely hates you.
Do you like making out with my Aunt Vicky?
That's a weird question.
So how's banging my mom working out for you?
Are you really asking me that?
Yeah, does my aunt make you queef?
What?
Oh my god, White, you're so fucking stupid.
Guys don't queef.
Wait, guys don't queef?
Yeah, no, they don't.
But what have I been doing?
Thing number eight, learning really messed up things about their past.
I'm so glad that you were my first.
Yeah, and I'm so glad you were my 52nd.
Yeah. What?
Well, I mean, unless you're counting third base, and then you'd be like 157th, but whatever.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Thing number nine, the fear of becoming a cliche, less desirable couple with absolutely zero love life.
Vlad, we really gotta sleep together today.
I'm judging the shit out of you on your tattoo choice.
How many tattoos I have is equal to how many annoying questions you're going to ask me this session.
Will it hurt? What hurts is you missed the 10 signs at the front of the studio demanding that you don't ask me that question.
I definitely didn't spell check this before I started tattooing. Oops-a-days.
Do a good job. Go f*** yourself.
Yep. 3 years of art school just to tattoo countless Southern crosses on pasty white guys' biceps.
Be nice to me, and I'll be nice to your intricate outline.
Are you sure you're not drunk? I kind of wish you were, because that tattoo design is really bad.
A tattoo of a woman crying? What a great idea! It's men like you that make this all worthwhile.
Oh, it's your first tattoo. Remind me again why I should care.
How long will it take? Well, that depends. Do you want this tattoo of your daughter to look like a smiley face? Or are you gonna let me do my job? Your call, buddy.
Another drunk guy's bare ass cheek? Is it my birthday? Oh, did mine hurt? No. Tattooists are a superior alien life form, completely immune to thousands of needles piercing through the skin. Now it's your turn.
You think it's too expensive? I think my time is too. See ya!
I went to sleep last night a little unsure, and then I woke up this morning and went,
right now, I keep going back and forth between good idea, bad idea, good idea, bad idea.
I feel great.
I feel like I'm gonna throw up.
The pain doesn't super intimidate me.
At this point, the less I think about it, I think the happier I'll be.
I'm getting an anchor on my wrist.
My tattoo is in memory of my cat, Maisie.
Yeah, I sent it to my girlfriend. She's like, yeah, do that one.
So my idea for a tattoo is a smiley face on the butt.
Let's do this thing.
All right. So we're thinking like...
Draw me like one of your French girls.
Is there a massage that comes with this as well?
You gotta pay
extra
for that.
Okay.
Oh, mama.
Oh, that sounds no fun at all.
Oh, man.
Tattoos are easy, guys.
Can you take a break? Can you take... Okay, cool. 1 second.
Halfway there.
Really? Oh my god.
It's really not anywhere nearly as painful as I thought it would be.
Oh man, I have to look tough.
It's like you're slowly stabbing me to death.
I hate getting my teeth cleaned way more than I hate this feeling.
I got this. This is so, so easy.
It is weird, like, as I'm doing this, like, realizing, like, this is forever.
And it hurts kind of. Is it over?
It's over. Officially over.
I got a tattoo.
What? Are you done?
Yeah, that's it.
That's it. Oh my god, you did it. You dealt with me.
I did it. I did it.
It's awesome.
Oh, there's a face on my butt.
I like can't believe this just happened.
I can't believe it's real.
We did it.
This feels like what I think cocaine would feel like right now.
Honestly, it feels like I just got off of a roller coaster.
I thought it was gonna hurt a lot more.
It feels like getting stung by little baby bees over and over again.
Dudes who complain about how much it hurts have never waxed their eyebrows before.
If you're thinking about getting a tattoo and pain is your biggest fear, like, do not worry at all. Maybe worry about the mistake that will haunt you for the rest of your life, like a smiley face on your butt, but don't worry about the pain. That's totally not a problem. I'm now thinking about this video living on YouTube and like the hundreds of thousands of people who are gonna see my butt, which in a way is more permanent than a tattoo will ever be.
My name is Sebastian Gonzalez, and I'm gonna be surprising my mom with the tattoo.
Honestly, we could get any number of reactions from my family.
Something about tattoos just speak to me. It's dope, but they wouldn't let me get one, so.
None of my family has ever gotten a tattoo.
I don't think my mom's gonna be too happy.
I ended up choosing a koi fish just because it fits in with the whole Zen vibe of my family.
I'll be getting a dragon tattoo. My mom's pretty smart, but also I really dig dragons.
A little bit nervous, but at the same time, I think this is gonna be great.
Kid was Sebastian growing up?
He was such a good kid. He just was always very, just listen.
Very proud of you, you know?
And just... I'd never want to do anything that would take away from that pride that you have in me.
Would you guys say that you have like a pretty open, you know, kind of relationship?
Well, I want to give him his space, but I would hope that he was honest with me, you know?
Yeah.
Do you remember when I was like talking to the two of you about Tom's birthday, like the weekend before last?
Yes.
And I got a little bit heavily under the influence. Well, there's like one other thing I ended up doing that night.
The real reason why I brought you here wasn't for really any of this.
What?
Just...
You sh**ed me, Sebastian. When'd you get that?
I got it like a couple weeks ago.
Your dad's gonna kill you, dude.
No, mom, no.
All right, so.
Oh my god,
fish?
It's beautiful.
I got a koi fish.
Was it painful?
I don't really remember.
Yo, well, good.
I wanted a tattoo, and you said you like personal space. I do what I want.
What is it?
It's like a dragon with smokes and stuff like that.
It looks like scribbles to me, Sebastian.
Oh, come on, Lana, you're just being mean.
Oh, my God. I love the koi fish. It's kind of tied in with
that's what I'm saying.
Papa Ross,
yeah, it's a family.
Dad, yeah. Who had a beautiful koi pond,
yep.
And who actually had a heart attack right next to his koi pond. And it was the most peaceful way for him to go. It was a blessing.
Do you even know, like, when you got the tattoo, like, what does it mean to you?
It means strength, resilience, and that I really like Lord of the Rings, so, yeah.
I don't know why I thought, you know, that you had gotten in trouble with the law or you decided to go sleep with a hooker, and I was like, oh, no. So a tattoo's mild.
I've gone through this with him before. I got a tattoo when I was 18. And now I'm, you know, 44 years old. I want to get it off. I'm disappointed. You know, at least talk to me about it. And especially that color.
Wow, wow. Yeah, I've considered tattoos myself.
What would you get for a tattoo?
Maybe an octopus. Thank God it wasn't a prostitute.
Is there anything else, I guess, that you want your mom to know?
Oh, more? Like, what else can you tell me? Oh, I mean, great.
All right, the tattoo's fake, Mom.
Let me see.
Look, the tattoo's fake, Mom. Like, you could scrape it off just barely.
I just want to give you one last look at the tattoo.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because it's actually going to wash off. It's not a real tattoo.
Okay. Really?
Yeah. You don't understand how much it was going to cost us to get that lasered off.
Who said I was going to get it lasered off?
I'm shaking. I'm so happy.
It's a beautiful tattoo, though.
You didn't want to go for something a little more masculine?
I want to give you your personal space, but like something like that is big, you know? Tagging yourself and doing that is not what makes you. You is what makes you.
Don't get an octopus tattoo.
Okay.
So I think the octopus would be a little
scary.
A little scary.
Hi guys, I'm Anision, and this is 10 Things I Hate About Wolverine. He's an alcoholic and a heavy smoker.
If you ever want to stop drinking, I know of a great AA group.
Yeah, okay, bub. How about you kill yourself?
He has major attitude problems.
Goddamn tiny knife! Goddamn useless tiny cell phones! Goddamn tiny penis!
He gets confused really easy.
Do you remember serving with me in World War II?
Remember? My head!
What?
He has no problem trying to steal other people's girlfriends.
So you got a girlfriend, bub?
If I wanted to, I could literally decapitate you with one punch.
But you won't. What's her number?
I could also fly your freshly decapitated head to Mars to make sure you don't regenerate.
Yeah, but you're too big of a pussy to do that, bubs. What's your name?
Her name is Lois.
Ah, got that bitch in lock.
He has one of the worst catchphrases ever.
I'm the best there is at what I do, but what I do isn't very nice. So you're basically a professional asshole. Dick.
He's useless against Magneto.
I don't have a Magneto costume, so I'm just gonna reenact what would happen if I met Magneto. Oh God, I can't move my body. Oh no, why are you taking off your pants, Magneto? Oh no, please. Oh God.
He's way too violent to fit in with a lot of superheroes.
So how do you stop the bad guys, pup?
I use highly tactical, non-lethal martial arts moves to incapacitate them. You...
Stab them in the chest repeatedly till they stop moving.
Superman, code 22.
You traitor!
Not that it's a bad thing, but in the comics, he's kind of a midget.
I'm gonna cut you down to size, pup.
Cut me down to midget size like you?
Hey!
He's extremely hairy and not very hygienic.
Why are you making that face, bub?
You smell like you pooped yourself.
Kill yourself.
Not only has he accidentally killed people before, he runs the risk of accidentally killing his friends with those blades.
Ugh, these claws are so uber cool.
Hey, Wolverine!
Oops, bub. Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs. Damn it!
There is a lot at stake here.
I didn't like him anyway. So...
Hello there!
Ignore the Christmas tree in the background.
I worship Satan. Let's talk about 10 things I hate about superheroes.
Thing number one!
Well, let's just figure out what it is. Really obvious alternate egos.
I'm Superman!
I'm Clark Kent.
Thing number two! They always let the villain live. Why?
Boom! It's over, Joker!
Congratulations, Superman. You've done what Batman never could.
What's that?
You've, killed the Joker.
I'm not gonna kill you.
What? Why?
Because I'm Superman. It's against my moral ethics.
But I've escaped prison many times!
Okay, then I'll stop you again.
After I kill more fleas, you mean?
Yeah.
I would say you're impotent. But I don't even believe you have a dick.
Yeah, I'm gonna pretend you didn't just say that and rise above hate.
Oh, fuck you!
Thing number three.
The imitation costumes! Good God!
Captain America's here!
And I'm gonna save your planet! Right after I eat this candy bar.
Thing number four. In real life, superheroes don't last very long.
About to fight me like a man, Joker!
Well, at least he went out with a bang! Oh, keep the barrel away from my face. Thing number five. They seem to always ignore logical alternatives.
I've got to stop that guy.
Hey.
What?
Why don't we just call the cops?
Because of Batman?
Yeah. Speaking of which, you're a billionaire. Why just pay people to do this for you?
Oh, because...
Like, seriously, you could get way more done having 20 guys work for you instead of doing everything yourself.
I never thought of it like that.
And like, if you die, Gotham slips back into darkness. But if they die, you just replace them.
Wow.
What?
My whole life is a fucking lie.
Well, I guess our job's done here.
We suck.
Thing number six. Popo, treat him like doo-doo.
So this man nearly sodomized and murdered 5 blonde-haired, blue-eyed boys, and I stopped him.
Yeah, we're gonna have to go and take you into custody, Mr. Superman.
What? Well, apparently, and I know this is crazy, being a vigilante is very illegal. So is sodomizing little kids, and I stopped that from happening.
Yeah, no, if you could go ahead and turn around, put your hands behind your back, that'd be great.
I'm gonna punch a hole through your fucking head.
Fuck! Thing number seven, a seemingly endless list of moron superheroes created by complete idiots that no one has heard about.
Hoodie Man!
The Swordless Ninja!
Demented looking guy with a machete!
Thing number eight,
embarrassing cosplay.
This is the front of a Batman costume which I paid $500 for. This is the back of the Batman costume I paid $500 for.
I wasted $500.
Thing number nine. The tights. I mean, come on.
Let's get this guy.
Or we could put on real clothes first.
Come on, we gotta get this guy.
I look fucking gay. No. Fag.
Thing number 10. Stupid, pointless abilities.
So what is it exactly that you do?
I shoot sperm out of my eyes.
Are you serious?
Yes, what is it that you can do?
I can shoot heat beams out of my eyes. I have super strength, super speed. I can fly. I'm nearly indestructible and a few other things.
Oh, damn.
What is it you can do again?
I can shoot sperm out of my eyes.
Okay, and you're here because?
I am applying to be in the Justice League.
No.
What?
I said no. You're not going to be in the Justice League.
Fuck you.
No, fuck you. Oh, yeah, really mature.
Onision.
My whole life is a fucking lie.
Belongs in a museum. Thank you. menagerie is for guests only.
The land serves me. Thank you.
I'm sorry if I seem uninterested or I'm not.
Alright, so this is Aaron.
Hi.
This will be doing my tattoo.
Sorry, morning correspondence.
This is the sketch of it. And it looks so cool. I'm really happy with it. So we are doing it right here.
Say goodbye to your blank upper arm.
I know. Look at my muscles. You guys wanna see this? Look it. I have some pretty good muscle. We're tight. Ow, that hurts. We're in the corner under clouds of marijuana with this boy who's hot, but I can hardly hear. Oh, with this music I don't listen to, and I don't wanna get with you. So tell my friends that I'll be over here. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, I ask myself, what am I doing here?
Good luck. All right,
to me. It feels great, guys. Now it feels like my arm is being sliced open.
I just imagine someone scratching me. That's the only way.
Yeah, I can't look at it actually.
Just scratching me, dude.
Yeah.
Alright, so there it is. The line work.
It looks so good. Just look at that. Look at those lines. Like, they're so smooth, and he just takes his time and he just does an amazing job. And this is obviously before it's shaded. We're going to shade it in now, as most as we can. Not there in the kitchen with the girl who's always gossiping about her friends. Will tell them I'll be here. Right next to the boy who's throwing up cause he can't take what's in his cup no more. Oh God, why am I here? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, I ask myself, what am I doing here? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And I can't wait so. Alright, so this is what it is currently. And it's almost done. This is probably like my favorite part right here. It's done, but it's gonna need probably like a week and a half to, or 2 weeks to heal up and not be so dark. So I'm pretty excited that it's done though. Okay, so my tattoo has officially healed. So this is my tattoo finished. And I love it so much. I am gonna go back to have this part kind of filled in a little bit more, just because I feel like it's now, like seeing it, I feel like it's kind of like bold and out there. But other than that, I'm like so happy with the way it turned out. I feel like it's exactly what I wanted. I wanted feminine, but I also wanted it to look, I don't know, I like it, it's pretty. You know, it's what I wanted and I'm so happy. So Aaron at North Main Tattoo, you are awesome, and thank you so much. So, yeah, all you guys like my crazy cat lady bracelet? I know. I hope I got some good clips. I did do this in a couple of different sessions just because of time, and he's, like, really booked, so there's not very much time open with him, so I had to, like, book a couple sessions. But a lot of the times, you know, you can go to an artist and do it in 1 day or 2 days or 2 sessions if you wanted to. So, but with me, we only had like a little bit of time for each session. So,
hey everyone. So today's video, I'm going to be doing all of my tattoos and piercings of a 14-year-old. Most people, it sounds ridiculous that a 14-year-old could even make this video, like all of her tattoos and piercings, but it is legal in my state to have tattoos and piercings. I didn't get these from friends, I got them from a legitimate tattoo shop. So yeah, so first off, we're going to be starting off with my piercings, which my first piercings were on my ears. So my first ever piercings was my first hole, obviously, and it was my mom got it done for me when I was super young, so I couldn't tell you the pain, but I do know low piercings they don't hurt. And I got this when I was about 2 months old, so. My second second piercing was my second hold, and I got my second holds done three times. The first time I got a second holds, or yeah, the first time I got them done, I just wasn't mature or old enough to know how to properly take care of a piercing, so it did not heal properly, so I had to take them out. The second time I got them pierced, about 2 days afterwards, they started hurting really, really badly, so my parents were like, just take them out, we'll get them re-pierced. And we tried to take them out, and my skin literally started growing around and attached to the earring. So I had to get it out with some pliers, and it was so painful. It took like an hour to get out. So that's the second time I got my second hole pierced. That was when I was about 9. First time I was about 9, second time I was about 10. The third and final time I got my second holes done was when I was 13, and second holes don't really hurt. It's a little bit of a stinging, like a burning, stinging, like really, really warm feeling, but it's not really painful. I wouldn't put it in the painful category. It's pretty much just kind of burning, about a 2 in pain, because it's not like it's painless, but it's not like it hurts really bad. 2 out of 5 stars. Third piercing I got was the same day I got my second holes done, and that was my third hole, and it's the same as the second. It doesn't hurt. And this is not the next piercing I had gotten, but I'm just going to be doing it because I'm just doing my ears first. So the fourth hole on my ear, I got when I was 14, so I'm 14 right now. I got it a couple months back, and I was actually kind of surprised with the pain for these ones. Like, they're... Yay! My brother's girlfriend passed her license test. The pain was kind of surprising. I was like, it kind of like stung really badly and like burned really bad. It was weird. Next piercing on my ears is my industrial. This is a total of 2 piercings. So the thing that sucks is once you think you're done with the piercing, you have to get it pierced again. But luckily it's not in the same place. It's not really a painful piercing. I was expecting it to hurt really bad, but an industrial piercing doesn't really hurt. It's just like a cartilage piercing, but it's kind of different. And if you don't know what an industrial piercing is, basically it's one piercing on each side of your ear, and it's basically a bar going through it. And I had to convince my parents to let me get this one. They did not want me having an industrial piercing, because like it's gonna get caught on everything. And actually, when I was telling my dad goodnight, he's like, okay, give me a hug. And I gave him a hug, and his bracelet got hooked on my industrial piercing, and he like took his hand away, and it ripped my industrial piercing and started bleeding all over the place. But luckily it is healed and it's all good. And my industrial piercing is really the piercing that's one of my favorites. That was this year. On this year, I have the same exact things, my quadruple holes. And then on up here, I have my cartilage. I got my cartilage. Oh, I got my industrial when I was 14. I got my cartilage done when I was 13. No, when I was 12. I got that when I was 12. And to be honest, I don't remember the pain on that one, but I remember it didn't hurt. The pain on my industrial was probably about a 3, because it wasn't painful, but it wasn't enjoyable. Then moving on to facial piercings. My first ever facial piercing that I got was my lip, and I've actually had my lip pierced 3 times, twice professionally, once by myself. And I initially got it done because, if you know who Luke Hemmings is, 5 Seconds of Summer, he has a lip ring, and I was just completely obsessed with it. I'm like, that's so cute. I love it. It's gonna look like crap on me, but Luke has one, so why not? So I got my lip pierced, and I absolutely loved it. The pain was a 0. I say it's a 0 because I didn't feel it. I had to ask the guy if the needle was through my lip yet because I just didn't feel it. It didn't hurt whatsoever. My second and my last facial piercing is my nose. And everybody says because it's cartilage, it's gonna hurt really, really badly. Nose piercings hurt. It does not hurt. At least for me, it didn't. I didn't really feel it. Like, you could feel a slight pinch, but that was pretty much it. And my nose ring is from Hot Topic, if you were wondering. My last piercing is my belly button. I got my belly button done around September of last year. And this piercing, let me tell you, if it closes up, I am not getting it re-pierced. I have gotten tattoos, I've got multiple piercings, but this piercing hurt so bad. And I'm gonna rate it a 5 because it was like unbearable pain. First tattoo, NCML, XXXV, and then the little eye things. And I got that tattoo for my brother. My brother passed away October 2014. So I wanted my first tattoo to be for him at my speech at his funeral. I said, my first tattoo is going to be for you. And so I went through with it, and my first tattoo I got from my brother. It means 1988, if you do not know. And it is a tattoo that is very near and dear to my heart, and I love it so much. And I'm actually planning on getting another tattoo for him because, but I'm planning on getting another tattoo for him. But
tonight, a tale of terrible tragedy.
I said I would drink a beer here from Luke Bryan on my stage, and yesterday I did that. I filmed this video like 3 days ago, and I was just like, I can't film it. So yeah, there it is. I lyrics tattooed on me. It is Luke Bryan's Drink a Beer, and it was on. And a final tattoo is the one on my wrist. And it says always, and it's an infinity sign, and I got it from my mom. Me and my mom, we both got matching tattoos. Not even that long ago. Only like a couple months ago. The thing I will say about this is the healing process sucked. It healed really weird. It was always like flaky. It's been flaky up until about this month, and I got it done about 6 months ago. So it was really weird. But I got the tattoo for my mom because she had been through certain things and she recovered from all of them. And I'm like, more celebratory thing was going to be matching tattoos. So we both have always on our wrist. She has hers higher up because she's scared to get it done here. So hers is higher up, but, and it's also facing the other way. Mine is facing me, hers is facing people. But yeah. Pain for this tattoo was, I'm gonna say a 3. Any pain for this tattoo, I'm going to say, was about 8. So that was all of my tattoos and piercings, and I just wanted to make this video because so many people ask about my tattoos and piercings. So yeah. And you get labeled so much when you're 14 with tattoos and piercings. Everybody's like, I thought you smoked weed, I thought you drank alcohol, I thought you partied all the time. I'm like, no, I'm an innocent little bean that's just covering her canvas.
For the life
finder. So, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you guys liked it, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. So, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.
Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Harmony Nice, and today I'm going to be doing a video all about my crap underage tattoos. So right, loads of people asked about this on my tattoo video, like that I'll link down below. I mentioned that I had some really shitty stick and poke tattoos and tattoos that were done underage with a tattoo gun, and I thought it would be kind of funny and you guys can just laugh at me and like, I have like 5 proper underage tattoos that I thought I'd just share with you today, and can't believe I'm doing this, but, well, sorry my voice is, like, really, really croaky. It's in the morning and I'm still really, really tired, so sorry about that, but let's get on with the video. So, the first ever tattoo I got is this one. Yeah, okay, so basically that is, believe it or not, this is actually supposed to be a music note and a peace sign. The music note is backwards, and I do know the music note is backwards. Oh my god. And the peace sign missing, like, one of the lines. I did not think it through, to be honest. Yeah, I got this one when I was 13. I actually just sat, like, in my bathroom and tattooed myself with a pin and some Indian ink, which is like what it suggested on the internet. I was like searching up like how to tattoo yourself, because I was like, that was the age of like getting into tattoos, and I was like, I'm gonna tattoo myself. But yeah, so I just like got a pin and some ink and like dipped it in and like tattooed myself. Didn't tie it to a pencil or anything, literally just like used that, because that's obviously a really good decision, isn't it? You can barely make out what it is now. Like, all of these tattoos, I will get covered up at some point, but they don't bother me, like, that much. It has faded, like, loads, because I obviously didn't do it properly, but, yeah. So, tattoo number two. I got this on my finger. That is a Roman numeral. Not quite sure what Roman numeral it is, but basically, when I first, like, joined YouTube to watch YouTube videos when I was like 14, I saw this girl called City in Makeup. She was the first ever YouTuber I watched. She doesn't make YouTube videos anymore, but yeah. And she had this tattooed to her finger. I don't even know what number it is. I'm not even sure, but I loved it so much. And I was like really bored one day at my friend's house, and I had been tattooing my friend. Yes, I've actually tattooed other people in the same manner, and yes, they're probably still just a shit. I was like, I'm gonna tattoo myself. So I tattooed this to my finger,